Furthermore, in his desire to implant in their youthful souls a root of modesty, he imposed upon these bigger boys a special rule. In the very streets they were to keep their two hands within the folds of the cloak. They were to walk in silence, and without turning their heads to gaze, now here, now there, but rather to keep their eyes fixed upon the ground before them. And hereby it would seem to be proved conclusively that, even in the matter of quiet bearing and sobriety, the masculine type may claim greater strength than that which we attribute to the nature of women. At any rate, you might sooner expect a stone image to find voice than one of those Spartan youths. To divert the eyes of some bronze statue were less difficult. And as to quiet bearing, no bride ever stepped in bridal bower with more natural modesty. Note them when they have reached the public table, the plainest answer to the question asked. That is all you need expect to hear from their lips. Part 4. But if he was thus careful in the education of the stripling, the Spartan lawgiver showed a still greater anxiety in dealing with those who had reached the prime of opening manhood, considering their immense importance to the city in the scale of good, if only they proved themselves the men they should be. He had only to look around to see what, wherever the spirit of emulation is most deeply seated, there, too, their choruses and gymnastic contests will present alike a far higher charm to eye and ear. And on the same principle, he persuaded himself that he needed only to confront his youthful warriors in the strife of valor, and with like result.